الحمد لله رب العالمين، الذي لا عز إلا في طاعته، ولا فلاح ولا نجاح إلا في التذلل لعظمته. هو الله الذي إذا أطعناه شكر، وإذا عصيناه وتبنا إليه تاب وغفر. هو الله الذي إذا دعوناه أجاب، وإذا عاملناه أثاب. سبحانه من إله حكم عدل، قلوب عباده إليه مفضية، وسرهم لديه علانية. الغيب لديه مكشوف، وكل أحد إليه ملهوف. عنت الوجوه لنور وجهه، ودلت الفطر على امتناع مثله وشبهه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، إلها واحداً أحداً جل عن الشبيه والنظير. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه، وأمينه على وحيه، وحبيبه وخليله. بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، وكشف الله تعالى به الغمة، وتركنا على محجة بيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فما أكرمه عبدا وسيدا، وما أبهره أصلا ومحتدا. أرسله الله تعالى رحمة للعالمين، ومحجة للسالكين، وقدوة للعاملين، وحجة على العباد أجمعين. فبصر الله تعالى به من العمى، وهدى به من الضلال. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين، وعلى أصحابه وأحبابه، ومن استنى بسنته واقتفى أثره ودعا بدعوته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، اتقوا الله عباد الله في سركم وفي علنكم، في ظاهركم وفي باطنكم، فإن تقوى الله عز وجل هي الوصية في الأولين وفي الآخرين، وهي خير زاد نلقى به رب العالمين. وصانا ربنا عز وجل بالتقوى في محكم التنزيل، فقال عز من قائل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس، اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل، وأحسن الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. ثم أما بعد، أيها المسلمون عباد الله، and to proceed my brothers and sisters in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started Surah Al-Hajj, chapter Al-Hajj, by saying عز من قائل: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. In this verse, Allah Azza wa Jal is saying, O mankind, fear Allah. O mankind, O people, Have consciousness of your Lord. Have the positive fear of your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. Indeed, the earthquake of the hour is a great thing. The earthquake of the last day of the resurrection day is a tremendous. The earthquake of the hour is terrible. إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. Allah عز وجل said, يَوْمَ تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا. In this day, every nursing mother and pregnant woman will abort, and you will see people drunk, even though if they are not drunk. But the torment of Allah is severe. So Allah Azza wa Jal is bringing our attention to the end of the earth. The people will live on earth generation after generation, until we arrive to the final generation of human being. And Prophet Muhammad said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the hour will not start until the earth is full of corrupted people. So the final generation on earth, overwhelmingly corrupted. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will start the hour with earthquake. You will see the mountain are shaken. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will explode the mountains, azza wa jal. You will see the floods and the hurricanes. The buildings and the towers will be collapsed. And no way to survive death in this moment. If you want to know about the earthquake of the hour, read the surah, Surah Al-Zalzalah. Allah Azza wa Jal said in this surah, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ يَصْدُرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا لِيُرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. If the earth is shaking its quake. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. And the earth will bring out its load. The human beings, the animals, the birds, everything in the earth will come out. The earth will kick everything out. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا. When man comes out of his grave, he will say, what is the matter? What is going on? What is happening? يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا. People will say, woe to us, who is resurrecting us from our graves. يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا. On that day, the earth will tell its news. The earth will be talking about the work that happened on the top of it. يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. It will tell its news. Do you know what is that? The earth will testify for the people or against the people. Imagine this earth that you are living above and walking on. It will speak in this day to testify for the believers and testify against the wrongdoers. The earth on that day will tell its news. يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا. the earth will speak because Allah Azza wa Jal did reveal to the earth to speak. Allah Azza wa Jal will command the earth to speak. يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها. يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم. People will be resurrected from their graves. They will be scattered on the earth again to review their works, to be confronted with their records. يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم, to see their deeds. And it will be like that, as Allah mentioned in the end of the surah. من يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. Whoever does a deed, and like an atom's weight of a deed, he will see it. If a person did an atom's weight of a deed, he will see it. If it's good, he will see good. And whoever does an atom's weight of a deed, of a bad deed, of an evil deed, he will see it. So every person will be confronted with his record. So this is a reminder from Allah, he revealed in his book, for people to think about the great earthquake that will end life on earth and will be the beginning of the last day, of the resurrection day. And from time to time, Allah reminds his servants with earthquakes. You may live 20 years or 30 years and then you see earthquakes, small earthquakes, to see how the earth will be shaken, how the earth will shake its quake. And nowadays, we started to see it every few months. In the past, people used to experience earthquake every 40 years, every 20 years, every 30 years. They experience earthquake. But now we are experiencing more earthquakes, more hurricanes, more floods, more deadly events. Exactly the way Prophet Muhammad said alayhi salatu was salam. Our Prophet said alayhi salatu was salam in hadith reported in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Imam Muslim and narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. He said alayhi salatu was salam, لا تقوم الساعة حتى يقبض العلم, حتى يقبض العلم ويتقارب ويتقارب الزمان وتكثر الزلازل وتظهر الفتن ويكثر الهرج. Before the hour, before the resurrection day, five things will happen. These are signs for the resurrection day. It tells that we are very close to the resurrection day. Number one, the knowledge will be taken. The knowledge will be taken. How Allah takes knowledge? By the death of the scholars. So that means when we are close to the day of judgment, we will start to lose our scholars one after the other. إن الله لا يقبض العلم انتزاعا ينتزعه من صدور الناس. Allah does not snatch the knowledge from the chests of people overnight, no? وإنما يقبض العلم بقبض العلماء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes back the knowledge by the death of the scholars. حتى إذا لم يبقى عالم أو حتى إذا لم يبقي عالما. Until there is no scholars will be remained. اتخذ الناس رؤوسا جهالا فسئلوا فأفتوا بغير علم فضلوا وأضلوا. So when people will lose the good scholars, they will follow ignorant religious leaders. So these ignorant religious leaders, when they are asked about the deen, they say false information and fabricated knowledge, misguiding themselves and misguiding others. So this is one of the signs of the Day of Judgment, that we are very close to the great earthquake, when the knowledge is taken back to Allah Azza wa Jal. And the second one, يتقارب الزمان, Allah will take His blessings from the time. So once you wake up in the morning, you find yourself about to sleep at night. We just pray in Jumu'ah, all of a sudden we have the second Jumu'ah comes. You don't feel the week. When the month is started, you find yourself at the end of the month. We just started the year, and the year is about to end. Subhanallah, what happened 3-4 years ago, as if it happened last day or 1 week ago. This is also a sign that we are very close to the Day of Judgment. يتقارب الزمان حتى يتقارب الزمان. The Prophet said that, عليه الصلاة والسلام, Allah will take His blessings from the time. If there is no knowledge, why people need time? If Allah will be taking away the knowledge as punishment to people, Allah will take away, Allah will take back the knowledge. So people don't need time. They will lose the blessings in their time. And then the Prophet said, وَتَكْثُرَ الزَّلَازِلِ. And then you will see a lot of earthquakes. A lot of earthquakes. We just heard about the earthquake of Syria and Turkey in February. It's less than 6 months. And we saw by our own eyes thousands of people lost their lives, and thousands of people lost their houses and their businesses. Complete cities vanished. I saw it by my eyes when I went to Turkey to deliver your relief and your support. I saw by my eyes. In Antakya, there was no building safe in the entire city. People, after they used to live in their houses and drive their fancy cars, they started to live in a tent in the street. And subhanallah, just less than 6 months, and we see an earthquake in Morocco, and hurricane in Libya, and thousands of people lost their lives, thousands of people lost their houses and businesses. Complete villages vanished, finished completely. And then the Prophet said, عليه السلام, وتظهر الفتن. People will face trials and temptations and tribulations. People will see fitan. Every fitna is enough to take the iman from the heart of the believer if he is not awake, if he is not staying upright upon the deen of Allah, if he is not getting himself ready to face the challenges of these fitan, he will lose his deen. وتظهر الفتن. He said, ويكثر الهرج. يكثر الهرج. People will act committing major sins, and الهرج, the scholars interpreted الهرج to be القتل. Even it will arrive to killing innocent soul for no reason. For no reason, people will be killing each other. These are signs that we are very close to the Day of Judgment. So now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strike an area with earthquake, what is the reason? What is the wisdom behind that? There is no doubt that Allah Azza wa Jal did create us to test us. Allah Azza wa Jal wants His servants to live on earth to face tests, to live a day of ease and day of hardship. Allah wants people, when they face the day of ease, to be thankful and to appreciate and to worship Allah more. And then when they face hardship, Allah wants to see their patience and their acceptance to His decree, Azza wa Jal. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow these earthquakes to happen to test the believers, to test his servants subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شُهَدَاءَ. Allah Azza wa Jal said he will know who are the true believers. In these tests, in this type of tests, Allah Azza wa Jal will know who are the true believers. It will be proved by their patience. They will stay on the deen, they will never complain. Whatever happened to them, they knew that this dunya is just little. It's temporary. In the sight of Allah has no value. Whatever they lose, they don't care. Whatever Allah did with them, they will remain upon the deen. It's a test. Allah will know who are the true believers. And he said, وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شُهَدَاءَ. Allah Azza wa Jal want to grant some of them the reward of martyrdom. Those who died under collapsed building are shuhada. Allah will grant him the reward of shahada. Those who die sinking in a flood or a sea, Allah will grant him the reward of shahada. As it is mentioned in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, reported in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, narrated also by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. If a person died under a collapsed building, he is a shaheed. If somebody is sinking in the water, he is a shaheed, if he is a believer. So Allah Azza wa Jal wants to see the strength of the iman of some of them. Allah wants to grant some of them the reward of martyrdom. And Allah Azza wa Jal wants to see their patience, because He rewards patience with uncounted reward. Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Allah rewards those who are patient without count. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is wisdom behind the earthquake. And there is a big wisdom also, that Allah wants to remind the wrongdoers to stop being the wrongdoers. Allah wants people to stop sinning, to stop violating Allah's laws. So how they stop? If the reminders of the prophets and the messengers and the reminders of the scholars and the student of knowledge is not working, people are safe, so they don't care. They have their house, they have their work, they drive their car, they have their money, they are not in pain, they are not sick. So they don't care about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes it from them. So they may wake up. Allah Azza wa Jal said in Surah Al-Sajda, Allah Azza wa Jal said in Surah Al-Sajda, وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that means Allah will make people taste small punishment before the bigger one in the day of judgment. Small punishment in dunya. So they may reflect, they may revert back to righteousness. They may repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. So one of the wisdom of this earthquake, to return people to Allah's path. And there is also another wisdom. There are people amongst us, completely kuffar, completely hypocrites, with dead hearts. Allah said about them, سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَأَنذَرْتَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Whether you remind them or not, they will never believe. They are just for corruption, doing evil and nothing but evil. So these people, the Muslims and the believers will get rid of them in events like the earthquake. The Prophet said, مُسْتَرَاح وَمُسْتَرَاح وَمُسْتَرِيح وَمُسْتَرَاح مِنْهُ. So some people passed away, they will be at rest after death. They will enjoy the reward of Allah. After they worked hard in dunya, obeying Allah Azza wa Jal, committed to their deen, the death will be like as rest for them. And some people, when they die, human being will have rest from them, will get rid of them. Because their presence in dunya is just evil and corruption. They do only corruption. Allah Azza wa Jal
said in the Quran that anything bad happened to us is because of us. We caused it because of our deed.
أولما أصابتكم مصيبة قد أصبتم مثليها قلتم أن هذا قل هو من عند أنفسكم. When a calamity happened to you, you are coming to say why it happened. It is because of you. Allah said that. And he said that to whom? To the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After they won in the battle of Badr, they lost in the battle of Uhud. Lost the 70 righteous leaders. And then the Prophet himself was injured. And the army of the Muslims were divided. And they, when they went to Hamra al-Asad with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they started to talk to each other. Why? We are the believers. We have our Prophet with us. We just were victorious one year ago. So what happened? Why we are suffering this defeat today? Allah said it is because of you. You caused it. When you was good, your victory was double their victory. Your victory is in Badr was double the victory of Quraysh in Uhud. He was not thankful. When you came to Uhud, you disobeyed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And once you disobey Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you deserve. So the punishment came. So when I was talking to some of our Moroccan brothers, they told me most of the areas of Marrakesh is for tourism. Full of people come from Europe for the warm weather. So the disobedience of Allah in these areas are more than any other area. So you see, the earthquake is striking a specific area to punish wrongdoers and to remind those who have some righteousness in their heart to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal and to grant to those who are suffering this bad environment to reward them the reward of martyrdom. So when we see an incident like this, yes, we are sad for our brothers. Yes. And yes, we will support them from the bottom of our hearts with our dua and our money. But in the same time, we need to learn the lesson and to know why Allah is shaking the earth under our feet. Allah is good. Allah is the Lord of righteousness. Why He is shaking the earth under our feet? Why Allah Azza wa Jalla is causing our buildings to collapse? Why He's allowing people to die under buildings and to be covered with the water in the hurricane and the flood? This is because of our deeds, because we are committing major sins and we are doing this as if it is permissible. We are doing the crimes as if it is halal. None of us is even feeling bad. So that's why we need to be strike to wake up before it's too late, because the punishment of the Day of Judgment is completely different. Everything you see now is just a small thing. Imagine if it is the great one of the Day of Judgment. So my brothers and sisters, learn your lesson from this. Learn your lesson. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a sincere repentance and to make us better Muslims and to keep us safe. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه سميع قريب مجيب. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك عليه في الأولين، وصل وسلم وزد وبارك عليه في الآخرين، وصل وسلم وزد وبارك عليه في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. My brothers and sisters, if we want to say something to our
Moroccan brothers who are in deep problem now. And to our brothers and sisters in Libya, we tell them there are few steps you need to take for Allah to make this trial easy and to end it quickly. Number one, restore your taqwa. Go back and fear Allah Azza wa Jal. Restore your taqwa. Have consciousness of your Lord. Allah said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. If you fear Allah, Allah Azza wa Jal will open an exit for you. This is one. Number two, we need to learn to know Allah in the time of ease, to know us in the time of hardship. Because some people, once they are safe, so they forget about Allah. And Prophet Muhammad said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, تعرف إلى الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. Know Allah in the time of ease, Allah will know you in the time of hardship. Number three, we need to keep the remembrance of Allah on our tongues all the time while we are facing this hardship. Allah Azza wa Jalla said about Yunus, فلولا أنه كان من المسبحين للبث في بطنه إلى يوم يبعثون. So Yunus alayhi salam, when he was in the stomach of the whale, Allah said, if he was not one of those who keep the tasbih of Allah on their tongues, if he was not one of those who keep their tongues moist with the tasbih of Allah, he would stay in the stomach of the whale forever. So his tasbih got him out quickly. His tasbih saved him. And number four, rely upon Allah Azza wa Jal to heal you, to cure you, and to get you out of this. Because Allah said in the Quran subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever rely upon Allah, Allah will be sufficient for him. If you really depend on Allah in your heart, if you know that there is no exit except by Allah, if you know that لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, you will never be able to change your condition from bad to good, and you will never have power to do anything without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we need to keep this in heart, التوكل على الله, relying upon Allah عز وجل. Also الدعاء, they make dua for themselves and we make dua for them. أما يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه وأكشف السوء. So Allah Azza wa Jalla is the one who helps those who are in trouble, those who are facing hardship. Allah is able to remove this hardship from them. Azza wa Jalla, He said, "Ad'uni astajib lakum." Invoke me, supplicate to me, ask me, I will help you. So we need to be humble, not to be arrogant, not to act as if we are not in need to our Lord. We need to show Him that we are His slaves. We have no way except by Him in our dua. So when we do it sincerely, Allah will accept it. We need to ask Allah Azza wa Jal and natawassal ilayh, to seek the means of His acceptance by our sincerity, to be truthful and sincere, and stop saying just talk without walk. We need to stop talking and to start doing what we are talking about. It's very important. Allah Azza wa Jal will relieve those who are in trouble. And my brothers and sisters, as we did with our brothers and sisters in Syria and Turkey few months ago, we raised the money in the masjid, and I went myself to distribute this help there among the victims. We will do same with our brothers in Morocco, bi-idhnillah, and other masajid will do with Libya. So today, inshallah, after the salah, we'll stand up to raise some money for our brothers there. It is their right upon us. If we really believe in brotherhood, if we really knew what brotherhood means, we will care about them. Imagine yourself at the beginning of the night sleeping in your bed, and in the morning you are in the street, you have no house. You have your wife and you don't know how to cover your wife. I saw that myself in Turkey. When I saw people in the street, a man with 5-6 daughters, and he's in the street living in a tent without even air condition or heat or anything. Living in a tent without house. There is no house anymore. No car, no business. They have nothing. All of a sudden became with nothing. It's a test. Not only for those who are suffering the calamity. No, it is also a test for us. Allah wanna see how we're gonna deal with this. Because our Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, مثل المؤمنين, the example of the believers, في توادهم وترحمهم وتعاطفهم كمثل الجسد الواحد. The way we love each other and support each other, the way we are loyal to each other, it's like one body. If part of the body is suffering, the rest of the body will suffer. We need to feel their pain to have المشاركة الوجدانية في الأفراح والأطراح between us as Muslims. When we see somebody happy, we feel happy for him. And when we see somebody sad, we feel sad for him. Try to help to get him out of his sadness. And whatever we spend for the sake of Allah is proof of our iman, proof of our truthfulness. And whatever we spend for the sake of Allah, Allah replaces it. As He promised, subhanahu wa ta'ala, He multiplies your donation and return it back to you in dunya and reward you for it in akhirah. And once you are in trouble, you will see people dealing with you the way you dealt with others. Now the way you think of your brothers and sisters in Morocco, people will think about you when you are in trouble. Because Allah said, وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. So these days will be alternated. You will have a day of safety. You are safe today, but you don't know what's going to happen to you tomorrow. So stand by those who are suffering this calamity today. So when you are in trouble, Allah will push people to stand by your side. Allah will move their hearts to feel for you. Allah will treat you the way you treat His servants, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is a chance after the salah to give some from your money and give it as soon as possible, because inshallah we'll be traveling on Sunday to do this. Inshallah tabaraka ta'ala. This week we will deliver a big support to our brothers and sisters in Morocco. About 17 masjid are raising money today, inshallah. The imams will be there delivering this help by their hands. And inshallah ta'ala, we will not cut any overhead cost from this money. If you donate $100, it will arrive $100. This is something is not mostly done in relief organizations, because they need to keep 10% or 15% or 20% for their operations and their salaries and stuff like that. Inshallah, your donation will arrive 100% bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. Make sure if you give zakah, make sure to tell us this is zakah, to deal with it as zakah money. It has its own way to be dealt with. And don't leave the masjid without supporting. Barakallahu feekum. أقول قولي هذا وأسأل الله عز وجل أن يغفر لي ولكم أجمعين وأن يهب المسيئين منا للمحسنين. اللهم اشرح صدورنا وأصلح قلوبنا وحصن فروجنا وردنا جميعا إلى دينك مردا جميلا. اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربانا صغارا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولأزواجنا وأولادنا وردنا جميعا إلى دينك مردا جميلا. اللهم أصلحنا وأزواجنا وأولادنا واجعلنا صالحين مصلحين. اللهم اهدنا واهد أزواجنا وأولادنا واجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم من أرادنا والإسلام والمسلمين بخير فوفقه إلى كل خير، ومن أرادنا والإسلام والمسلمين بشر فاجعل كيده في نحره، واجعل تدبيره تدميره، واجعل الدائرة عليه يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تخرج إخواننا في المغرب من هذه الضائقة. اللهم هون عليهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل شهداءهم وارحم موتاهم وداوي جرحاهم. اللهم واخلف عليهم ما أخذت منهم يا عزيز يا كريم. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تخفف عنهم مصابهم. اللهم خذ من أموالنا لهم حتى ترضى. اللهم خذ من أموالنا لهم اليوم حتى ترضى. اللهم خذ من أموالنا لهم اليوم حتى ترضى. وصل يا ربنا وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد، والحمد لله رب العالمين. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله. أقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استووا، استووا. الله أكبر، الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله، إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى، ونيسرك لليسرى، فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى. سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى، الذي يصلى النار الكبرى، ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا، قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى. بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا، والآخرة خير وأبقى. إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى، صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
العالمين. إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.